Welcome, friends. I am Kay Simpson, and this is Faith Community Church 5 Before Podcast. And this week, we've been talking all week about in the Bible where it says, ask and seek and knock and find. And typically, we go look in Matthew in 7:7. And I just kind of was struck by the word seek. And I know we've talked about all the different ones as the week has gone on. But for me, that kind of just really stuck out for me. And then in John's sermon on Sunday, he was really reminding us, y'all, of how we look like, who we hang around and who we are around and who we spend time with. And he was telling us in order to look like Jesus, we really needed to spend time with him. So to me, it was saying to really seek his face and come expectantly, like seek him, ask for what we need and knock on the gate. And just a big reminder that he really is the way. He is the gate and the gatekeeper. And so I found in Jeremiah 29:13, it says, you will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. So again, it's reminding us to seek and find, and that we will find him when we seek him. It's telling us to seek him. And that was in the Message version. And when you come looking for me, it says, you'll find me. This is the Message version. Listen to this. When you come looking for me, you'll find me. Yes, when you get serious about finding me and want it more than anything else, I'll make sure that you won't be disappointed. Seek the Lord, seek his face. And we just need to really seek face-to-face time with him. He is always there. He is always waiting. It really should be our number one priority. And I loved again in the sermon on Sunday when he talked about how as parents, we all love to have our kids come to the house, or anytime any loved one is just coming to spend time with you, or you know you're going to get to see them, even if it's on vacation, how sweet and what a treasure that is, and how I feel like the Lord has to feel the same way when he knows that we are seeking him, we're seeking that one-on-one time with him. And so that was just a good reminder to seek his presence, you know, seek spending that quiet time with him. And that, you know, we don't have to wait for him. Basically, he is waiting on us. And so just to search him out, you know, and be intentional. Sometimes I even have to write it in my calendar, write it in my journal. You know, tomorrow morning I'm going to spend this time with him, because if not, the time just gets away from us and we just forget how important that is. So if we make it our number one priority, just kind of schedule that in and make that appointment with him. That's true. You could just make an appointment. So look at Luke 11. It says, the man was consistently going to his neighbor. He was knocking on the door because he wanted some bread. And he was knocking and knocking and knocking. And the neighbor didn't want to get out of the bed. But finally he did. Finally he answered the guy's request. So I love this in the Passion Translation when it says, Luke 11, and it's verse 9 and 10. So it is with your prayers. Ask and you'll receive. Seek and you'll discover. Knock on heaven's door and it will one day open for you. Every persistent person will get what he asks for. Every persistent seeker will discover what he needs. And everyone who knocks persistently will one day find an open door. It doesn't say tomorrow, but it says we will find an open door if we just persistently seek and persistently knock. So it reminds me that, you know, we have a good father. It is not just, I think when we hear the word father, we often relate it to earthly fathers or earthly men or earthly individuals that we know, and we forget that he is like the perfect heavenly father. And so he is going to do anything he can to listen to us and give us what we're asking for. So I think for me, I just have to adjust my prayers to know that he is the perfect father and he loves me and he wants to answer whatever I'm seeking him for. So our reminder this week is, let's keep asking, seeking, and knocking so that he will open the door. So amen to that. Let me pray for us. Lord, I just thank you so much for this reminder that we need this word this week to ask, to seek, to knock, and then we will find, and how it is just consistently over and over in the Bible to come and seek your face. I think it's just in there so many times that we just skip over it sometimes and we forget that we have that ability to just stop whatever we're doing and sit and seek some time with you and seek your presence and how you will show up and how you will answer our prayers. And I just thank you that you're a good, loving Father. I just thank you for the reminder. We love you, Lord. Amen. All right, guys, have a great day and have a great weekend.